Welcome to the UNC Library's Census Short Take series. What's a FIPS code? FIPS stands for Federal Information Processing Standard, and here's the technical definition. But you can think of a FIPS code as a unique identifier for a geography, just like a Social Security number is for a taxpayer, or an ORCID ID is for a researcher. It's a quick, standard way to refer to a specific geography. FIPS codes look different at different levels of geography. Here are some for commonly used geographies to give you a sense of what they look like. State codes are 2 digits, county codes are 3 digits, tracts are 3 digits, sometimes with a 2-digit decimal number, block groups are 1 digit, and census blocks are 3-digit. Block group numbers are usually not presented separately from census block numbers on census maps. Instead, the two are usually displayed together as 1 4-digit number, such as 3026, where 3 is the block group number and 026 is the census block number. Notice that the first or even first and second digits may be zero. These are called leading zeros, and you may have to take special steps to preserve them. For instance, in Excel, you would need to format cells containing FIPS codes as text to prevent the program from treating them as ordinary numbers and dropping the leading zeros. You wouldn't drop a starting zero from a zip code, right? FIPS codes need those zeros too. The tricky thing about FIPS codes is that codes at lower levels of geography can repeat across larger levels of geography. For example, here you can see Alamance County highlighted in North Carolina. It has the county code 001. But then Autauga County in Alabama also has county code 001. So the state and county codes are used together to make a unique identifier for each county. If you're only working within one state, you only need FIPS codes to the county level to ensure unique codes. But it's good to get in the habit of using complete FIPS codes all the way to the state level. If you ever see geocodes broken down into separate columns or fields like this, and you plan to use the data in a GIS map, you must concatenate the several columns into one for your map to recognize the FIPS codes. This illustration shows the concatenate function in Excel in cell F1. And here are the fully concatenated codes in column F. To repeat, FIPS codes are only unique when the whole code is combined in one field, including any leading zeros. If you need help finding FIPS codes in census data or have any other questions, please contact me.